coming.
Well, I think it showed up last year in that our play improved a great deal defensively. We kept us in ball games and really allowed us to come back in several of them in the second half to get some wins and stuff like that. So I thought we made a lot of progress last year over the previous year defensively. Now, coming into this year, we've got a lot of those guys back. We've got our same coaches back, Bob Shoup running our defense, which that's a big plus. They all understand each other. You know, we lost an outstanding defensive player, and Derek Cox got picked for the third round by the Jacksonville Jaguars. And, you know, I don't think we got anybody to take his spot right now, but we do have some other guys that can make play. And I think the biggest thing I look at it on our defense is the experience and the ability of our front four. You know, you mentioned, you know, Adrian there at the defensive end, Sean Lissamore inside, and then we've got four or five other guys that can line up and play and mix it up and can really give us depth and good play up front. Well, yeah, I think you know, every year your offense changes a little bit anyway, and that's one of the things that we attempt to do every year is build our offense around our quarterback. Take advantage of what our quarterback can do and really try to delete things that he can't do real well. Don't put him in too many bad situations. And Jake had done a good job for us the last couple of years. RJ made a heck of a sacrifice, I think, for our football team last year, because the previous 2 years he'd been starting at wide receiver. And I said, we got to go into the year. I can't go in with just one quarterback with Jake. So I wanted him to be our backup quarterback. And he worked at it. He learned. He got to play, played the whole game against Villanova, did well, played some other games and picked up valuable experience. So now it's his time to take over. And I think he probably gives us a little bit more of a mobility dimension than Jake did. He doesn't have the experience that Jake had, but he's got the good arm, he's got good mobility, and I think he will improve as the year goes on.
With the sacrifices that he made, as you mentioned, was it more because you needed a good quality backup with Jake, or were you looking to project him to be the future quarterback?
Both. Okay. Both. Yeah. First, you know, I wanted to have two good quarterbacks. I had the opportunity of having two good ones, and, you know, the drop off would have been significant if RJ had not been there at quarterback. And then the other thing is, you always got to plan ahead, say, okay, who are we going to have coming up? You know, and it allows us now a little bit more time to bring in some young guys and develop some young guys. And now we got a good seasoned guy to take over and play quarterback who has had maybe not all his game experience has been a quarterback, but he's got a lot of game experience. I wasn't surprised by his ability. I was surprised at how quickly he played with that ability. We were not expecting to play him as a freshman, and I knew he was a good player, but I probably didn't know he was that good that fast. But he did well, and John will get better. He'll continue to get better, more experienced and understanding because of the type of young man that he is. The only way I can get him to slow down at practice is to take him out. I cannot tell. I've tried to tell. I said, John, slow down. Take this one 3/4. Take this one 1/2 speed. He can't do that. He just can't do it. So I said, well, okay, I'll give you a break. But he goes 100% every time, and he'll get even better.